Hey everyone, it's Lizzie, and on my channel, we help families find freedom in finances. And one of them is how you can minimalize your grocery budget. So today I will be showing you guys my grocery haul, and I personally went to Walmart. I did the Walmart grocery pickup because I love that type of service. I personally do not like going to the grocery store and buying things myself. Sometimes, you know, it's worth it. Other times, it's just not worth it to me because it takes so much time. So I currently have the little mini haul behind me. But before I get into showing you guys my grocery haul, I wanted to do a little price comparison to Walmart and Aldi. But before I do that, let me just rewind. This is my meal plan and my grocery list that I have for this week. So let me show you guys that, and then we'll get into the price comparison. So first thing you are going to want to do is do your inventory, what you have on hand, what you want to use up. So this is my current grocery inventory. I just went through our fridge, freezer, our pantry, and I just wrote in some items that I see that are either about to go bad or I just want to kind of get rid of it and get something new. So these are my items. And then the next thing that I'm going to want to do is create my meal plan. So with the items that I went through and I made my inventory, I can then find recipes or go through my cookbooks and figure out some recipes that can go with that item. So first meal I will be making is a teriyaki tofu with broccoli and white rice. I have all of those things on hand. I have everything. So I don't have to purchase anything from the grocery store for this meal. We'll be having leftovers because I'll be making enough food for today. I'm actually filming this on the Sunday before. The next item is Mexican lasagna. I have the filling, I just don't have the sauce. So that is something that I'm gonna supplement and put it on my grocery list, which we'll get into that in just a minute. The next meal item that I will be making is a chickpea and avocado salad sandwich. I have everything for this as well. I think it's just some, the bread probably that I would need to get. Well, no, actually we do have bread. So I have everything that I need for this meal as well. I would have to get some more avocados that I know I did put on my grocery list. The next thing on a Friday, so Fridays is kind of a relaxing day for us. We get home from work. We don't really want to spend a lot of time cooking, and also one of my goals is to eat out less. So we will just be having burgers with fries. Only thing that we don't have is the buns and the fries for that meal. So I know that that's going to save on our grocery budget. And then for Saturday, we'll just have some grilled cheese, and that's with the vegan cheese. If you don't know, I am plant-based and so is my husband. We recently made the switch in November. So then once we got that out of the way, this is the grocery list. I do have some household items on here. Last week, I didn't get the doggy bag, so I'm including that in this week as well. If you saw my last grocery haul, you know what I'm talking about. So these are the current items that I need to purchase in order to complete the meal plan for the week. This is crucial in order for you to lower your grocery budget. When you have your grocery list created, you can go shopping. So I personally, as I mentioned in the beginning, I love using a pickup service or a delivery service for my groceries. It just saves me so much time and it's just so convenient. However, you do want to take into account that there are some differences in prices when you do like an Instacart. They mark it up just like maybe a few cents, maybe 10 cents or so, because they are doing the shopping for you. And there is like fees involved with that. Guys, right here, I'm gonna put it up on the screen, the photo. With the items that I have marked on the grocery list, I compared it to Aldi and I also compared it to Walmart. I made two separate lists. Now, Aldi did not have some of the items that I needed, like for example, my dog food and the doggy bags and things like that, some of the seasonings that I needed. So I just did this comparison, not including everything on my grocery list. So You're gonna see that Aldi is slightly more expensive than Walmart is. So keep that in mind. Aldi is not necessarily less expensive, especially when it comes to like this type of pickup service. If you go in person and you're very picky when it comes to that, by all means, go shop in person and pick up your own items. I have found a great experience myself with utilizing pickup grocery service. So I will most likely still continue to do it because I'm able to do cleaning at home while somebody's doing my grocery shopping. But anyways, yeah, that is something that was definitely eye-opening for me when I was doing this and when I was making the list. So because Aldi doesn't have like all of the household items, I chose not to go with them and I just chose to do my Walmart pickup service. So with the Walmart grocery pickup service, sometimes they don't have some items on hand, so they will alert you and say, would you like to replace this item? Sometimes they just don't have anything on hand and they just won't give you a replacement at all. So there's one item that I wasn't able to get. I even went to another store after I picked it up and they didn't have it, and it's the bay leaves. So it's for my stew and that really completes it. And yeah, you're seeing all these pillows in the background. Anyways, so let me go ahead and show you my grocery haul and show you what the total cost of everything was. So this is my little grocery haul that I have. They had everything except for one item. They didn't have the bay leaf, as I mentioned. I have the substitutions over there that I'll show you in a minute. But let's start off with showing you guys everything I got. We have the brown sugar. I got these buns for the burgers. As I mentioned, we are plant-based, so we have to be very aware of like what we are consuming. And these are really, really good. Even if you're not plant-based, like these are really good buns. We got the extra virgin olive oil, the oat milk. We got the enchilada sauce. What is this for? I don't even remember. I have to go through my recipes. I have it saved on my Pinterest board under Yum. So you can follow me over there, Naturally Lizzie on Pinterest. And I have like a bunch of different recipes. Even if you're not plant-based, I have a whole bunch that I have tried personally. We have the minced garlic in water. And guys, these burritos, we have tried them before and they were actually really good. So I got two of the different flavors, but these are plant-based burritos and they're like beef style. And then there's this one that's the chicken fajita burritos. So I did write on my meal plan itself that we were gonna have burritos for lunch one day. I did not write it in my grocery list, however. So yes, I did miss that on my grocery list, but I knew to get them anyways. We got the fries, some avocados here, really small bananas. I normally pick out bigger ones, but that's okay. We have some tomatoes here. And then that's pretty much it for the grocery section. And then we have our substitution items. So I did need some jalapeno slices. And I guess that the brand that I had chosen was no longer in stock, so they just replaced it with an equal price or less price item. So just keep that in mind. But I did get the jalapeno slices, which was really, really important to me. And then this is the dog food that we get our dogs. We get the ones that are in like the really large, like sausage looking thing, but they didn't have the larger ones in stock. So they just gave us two of these small ones and it was way under the cost of what I initially thought it was to be. So now these are like the little household slash pet items. We did need the doggy bag. So I got a whole thing of doggy bags and then some garbage bags because we were running low on having our garbage bags. So as you can see right down here, the total was $54.71. And it shows you your digital receipt of what every individual item cost. And then also right up top, it shows you what item was out of stock, which is the bay leaves. The bay leaves were out of stock and I couldn't find them anywhere. And then the items that they replaced. So it was the same brand, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what happened. Very interesting. I ordered a 12 ounce and they gave me a 32 ounce for the same price. So hey, That's good. And then this is the fresh pet item that I did select. It's about $13, but they only gave me two of those. They could have given me more, but maybe they didn't have any more. So that is how the receipt shows up in your email after you have selected your items. So that is my haul. That is all for today's video. As I mentioned, I do enjoy the convenience of grocery pickup. If you want to try it out, I have a coupon code in the description. If you use my link, you can try out Instacart, you can try out Walmart grocery pickup, whatever you'd like. It's completely free for you to try it out and get a, you know, like a saving, so why not? But if you did enjoy today's video, then be sure to hit the thumbs up button. Let me know what other type of videos that you would like to see me do. I love to hear from you guys, but that is all. And I will see you guys in a brand new video. Bye guys.